Hello and a very warm welcome to the Oriel Singers Carols by Candlelight 2020. What follows is a selection of carols recorded in October and December this year when we had that glimmer of joy that is making music together. These audio recordings are accompanied by seasonal images and pictures of the choir taken prior to the pandemic. There are a couple of carols for you to join in with and our usual selection of readings that punctuate the music. Before this starts, I would like to draw your attention to the choir's mailing list and information about becoming a friend of the Oriel Singers. And you can find out more by clicking on the link in the description below. Now, sit back and enjoy some festive cheer with our Carols by Candlelight.
Not to start to say. Annunciation by Denise Levertov. We know the scene, the room variously furnished, almost always a lectern, a book, always the tall lily. Arrived on solemn grandeur of great wings, the angelic ambassador standing or hovering, whom she acknowledges a guest. But we are told of meek obedience. No one mentions courage. The engendering spirit did not enter her without consent. God waited. She was free to accept or to refuse, choice integral to humanness. Aren't there annunciations of one sort or another in most lives? Some unwillingly undertake great destinies, enact them in sullen pride, uncomprehending. More often, those moments when roads of light and storm open from darkness in a man or a woman are turned away from in dread, in a wave of weakness, in despair, and with relief. Ordinary lives continue. God does not smite them. But the gates close. The pathway vanishes. She had been a child who played, ate, slept like any other child, but unlike others, wept only for pity, laughed in joy, not triumph. Compassion and intelligence fused in her, indivisible. Called to a destiny more momentous than any in all of time, she did not quail, only asked a simple, "How can this be?" And gravely, courteously, took to heart the angel's reply, the astounding ministry she was offered, to bear in her womb infinite weight and lightness, to carry in hidden, finite inwardness, 9 months of eternity, to contain in slender vase of being the sum of power, in narrow flesh the sum of light, then bring to birth, push out into air, a man-child, needing, like any other, milk and love. But who was God?
Oh.
Time for Us Girls by Pam Ayres, written in this year of COVID. I'm normally a social girl. I love to meet my mates. But lately with the virus here, we can't go out the gates. You see, we are the oldies now. We need to stay inside. They haven't seen us for a while. They'll think we've upped and died. They'll never know the things we did before we got this old. There wasn't any Facebook, so not everything was told. We may seem sweet old ladies who would never be uncouth, but we grew up in the 60s. If you only knew the truth, there was sex and drugs and rock and roll, the pill and miniskirts. We smoked, we drank, we partied. We were quite outrageous flirts. And then we settled down, got married, turned into someone's mum, somebody's wife, then Nana. Who on earth did we become? We didn't mind the change of pace because our lives were full, but to bury us before we're dead, it's like a red rag to a bull. So here you find me stuck inside for 4 weeks or maybe more. I finally found myself again, and then I had to close the door. It didn't really bother me. I'd while away the hour, I'd bake for all the family. But I've got no flaming flour. Now, Netflix is just wonderful. I like a gutsy thriller. I'm swooning over Idris or some randy, sexy killer. At least I've got a stash of booze, and when I am being idle, there's wine and whiskey, and even gin if I'm feeling suicidal. So let's all drink to lockdown, to recovery and health, and hope this awful virus doesn't decimate our wealth. We'll all get back and through this crisis. We'll be back and to join our mates. And I'm hoping I'm not too far wide to fit through the flaming gates.
Gaudete, Christus est natus. Advent 1955 by John Betjeman. The Advent wind begins to stir with sea-like sounds in our Scotch fir. It's dark at breakfast, dark at tea, and in between we only see clouds hurrying across the sky, and rain-wet roads the wind blows dry, and branches bending to the gale against grey skies all silver pale. The world seems travelling into space, and travelling at a faster pace than in the leisured summer weather when we and it sit out together. For now we feel the world spin round on some momentous journey bound. Journey to what? To whom? To where? The Advent bells call out, "Prepare! Your world is journeying to the birth of God made man for us on earth." And how, in fact, do we prepare the great day that waits us there, for the 25th day of December, the birth of Christ? For some, it means an interchange of hunting scenes on coloured cards. And I remember last year, I sent out 20 yards, laid end to end, of Christmas cards to people that I scarcely know. They sent a card to me, and so I had to send one back. Oh dear, is this a form of Christmas cheer? Or is it, which is less surprising, my pride gone in for advertising? The only cards that really count are that extremely small amount from real friends who keep in touch and are not rich but love us much. Some ways indeed are very odd, by which we hail the birth of God. We raise the price of things in shops. We give plain boxes fancy tops, and lines which traders cannot sell, thus parcelled, go extremely well. We dole out bribes we call a present to those to whom we must be pleasant for business reasons. Our defence is these bribes are charged against expenses and bring relief in income tax. Enough of these unworthy cracks. The time draws near the birth of Christ. A present that cannot be priced, given 2,000 years ago, yet if God had not given so, he still would be a distant stranger and not the baby in the manger.
Oh,
thank you so much for joining us for our Christmas offering. We very much hope that we can meet together to celebrate with you in 2021. And don't forget to sign up to the mailing list to receive all the information about when the Oriel Singers will next perform. That just leaves me to wish you a safe, healthy and very merry Christmas.
We wish you